seminar on brake gear adjustments on wagons. Agenda: by the end of the session, we come to know importance of SWTR, SWTR procedure, undergear arrangement, load empty arrangement, handbrake arrangement. Importance of single wagon test rig. Single wagon test is performed on a wagon to ensure proper functioning of the air brake system. Single wagon test is performed by using portable device called single wagon test rig. The source of compressed air for conducting the test is obtained through a compressor. The single wagon test rig procedure is as follows. Couple up all brake gear arrangements such as undergear fitting, load empty device and handbrake. Now let us have a look of undergear arrangement. Sole bar, brake cylinder, crossbar, brake cylinder, dead horizontal lever, live horizontal lever, bush, the arrow mark indicates the bush placement, long tail pin of size 34 by 183 mm and bush 34 mm, brake cylinder pin. The empty tie rod arrangement is as follows. Empty tie rod pin on dead horizontal lever and live horizontal lever. Loaded tie rod of size 920 mm slot BC side. Empty tie rod of length 900 mm. Load tie rod pin. Main pull rod of size 1518 mm. Here, the SAB mechanism is as follows. SAB control rod 1250 mm. Short tail pin. SAB pin. Let us have a detailed view of load empty arrangement. In empty condition, the catch will hold the empty tie rod. Whereas in loaded condition, the catch will unhold the empty tie rod. And moves forward for the effective brake application. Now, let us take a look of load empty setup to LSD or APM conversion. Due to the provision of automatic two-stage load device, higher brake power is obtained in loaded condition compared to that of conventional manual empty load device. Further, by providing APM, pressure transformer and load sensing device were eliminated. Hence, pressure transformer and load sensing device is equal to automatic pressure modification device. Now take a look of handbrake arrangement. Sole bar, brake cylinder crossbar, front floor channel, brake cylinder, live lever, supporting bracket also known as J-hook, short equalizing lever, gearbox, bevel gears of two numbers, screw rod with nut, it should be in parallel, long equalizing lever, palm rod, short spindle rod, sleeve bush with rivets, long spindle rod, handbrake wheel. Let us pay attention to operation of handbrake. Here follows the BMBS handbrake operation. Screw rod reverse direction as compared to conventional wagons. Indicator. If BC not released while handbrake is in off position, don't hit the indicator. Handbrake in off position, if BC was not released, disconnect the D-link. After that also, if BC not released, that means BC or cables or indicator is defective. If BC released, that means handbrake arrangement wrong. The single wagon test rig procedure is as follows. Set the A dimension as given and check the E dimension. The formula for the calculation of A dimension is the product of bogie leverage and number of bogies and clearance between brake block and wheel divided by number of SAB in a wagon. A dimension. In slack adjuster, the A dimension is the controlling feature. A dimension is the distance measured between the control rod head and the barrel when the brakes are fully released. A dimension corresponds to the correct slack when brakes are fully released, and it differs from wagon to wagon. Hence, when A dimension gauge is set up between the control rod head and barrel, the clearance between the brake block and wheel is 5.9 mm. E-dimension. E-dimension is the distance between the end of the protective sleeve of the screw and the grooved mark on the screw rod when the screw rod is in fully released, and hence limit of length that adjuster will adjust is 555 plus or minus 20 mm. These A and E dimensions should be maintained under all working conditions. Single wagon test rig procedure. Record the brake cylinder piston strokes in empty and loaded conditions for different wagons as per the standards. Now have a look of how brake cylinder application takes place. During brake cylinder application, the piston in the brake cylinder moves forward, as a result of which the horizontal levers move towards each other. Accordingly, the main pull rod, control rod and short pull rod move towards SAB, and brakes are applied by the movement of brake blocks towards wheel. Single wagon test rig procedure. If the piston strokes are not within the limit, the brake equipment should be thoroughly examined. If the piston strokes exceed the maximum limits prescribed, examine thoroughly. The main pull rod lengths for different types of wagons are as follows, as well as the short pull rod lengths. Significance of holes. A indicates the outermost hole of bogie and pull rod. Distance between two consecutive holes are 37 mm. Indian Railways introduced bogie mounted brake system. BMBS system eliminates all the mechanical undergear components. Bogie mounted brake system. Here follows the parts: wheel set, primary beam, secondary beam, bell crank lever, BC pin, I pin, clevis pin, push rods, brake block. Here the arrow marks indicates the direction of three pins movement of bell crank lever, that is, blue color BC pin indicates the direction of BC on both sides. Red color clevis pin indicates the direction of secondary beam via push rods on both sides. Green color I pin indicates the direction of primary beam on both sides. That is, BMBS works according to the Newton's third law of motion. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. In this regard, action refers to the movement of BC piston towards indicator side bell crank lever, and the opposite reaction refers to the backward movement of BC head side bell crank lever. Due to both forward and backward application, the BC extends equally on both sides, that is, bidirectional application takes place. Single wagon test rig procedure is as follows. Ensure the brakes are completely released and piston regained to its original position.